The following question reads that which molecule has the largest overall dipole? The molecules that are going to have the largest overall dipole are the ones that will have a difference in electronegativity, and the dipoles are not going to cancel each other out. Let's first look at option A. Option A only has carbon and hydrogen atoms. Remember that carbon and hydrogen atoms have almost similar electronegativity. So if they have similar electronegativity, so the electrons are going to be evenly distributed between the atoms. So the electrons are not going to be closer to any of the atoms. They are equally electronegative. So this first molecule, option A, is not going to have any overall dipole. Let's now talk about option B. If you look at option B, it has carbon and hydrogen atoms, and there's an oxygen atom over here. Remember, oxygen is very electronegative. So oxygen is to the right of the periodic table. Elements that are to the right and to the top of the periodic table are the ones that are electronegative. So oxygen is going to try and pull these electrons closer to it. And this side of the molecule will get a partial negative charge because all the electrons would be closer to this oxygen atom and they would be away from all the other atoms. So the other side of the molecule would have a partial positive charge. So this molecule is going to have an overall dipole because it has a very electronegative atom attached on one side and all the electrons are being pulled towards that side. But let's check out option C as well. If you look at option C has oxygen atoms and chlorine atoms. If you look at the periodic table, so I've opened the periodic table and you can notice that oxygen is over here and chlorine is over here. So they're both on the extreme right side and extreme top side of the periodic table. So both are equally electronegative. They almost have similar electronegativity. So going back to the question, since all three atoms are equally electronegative, this chlorine would try to pull electrons towards itself. This chlorine would try and pull electrons towards itself. And the oxygen is going to try and pull electrons towards itself. So all three atoms the surrounding three atoms are equally electronegative. They're all trying to gain electrons. But the forces of attraction are going to get cancelled out. And over here, there is not going to be any overall dipole because the dipole or the forces of attraction is eventually going to cancel out. Similarly, if you look at option D as well, in option D you have carbon and hydrogen atoms and you have a very electronegative chlorine atom attached on two ends. So this chlorine over here is trying to pull electrons towards itself. This other chlorine is also trying to pull electrons towards itself. Chlorine is highly electronegative. It's trying to gain electrons, but since both chlorines are on opposite sides of the molecules, the forces of attraction, this chlorine pulling electrons towards itself, this other chlorine over here trying to pull electrons towards itself. Over here, the forces of attraction are going to get cancelled out. So there's not going to be any overall dipole because the dipole cancels out as well. And the electrons are going to remain evenly distributed. They're not going to go on one side. So if you look back at all the options, there was only one option, option B, which had an overall dipole, where there was one oxygen atom on one side, so all the electrons got dragged or pulled towards that side. So only option B has a dipole. In option C and D, the dipoles are cancelling out, whereas in option A, there was no initial dipole. All the atoms were equally electronegative. So the correct answer is going to be option B.